This is the pathway Cyclone Idai has taken across Mozambique. With 107 mile per hour winds came torrential rain. As the floodwaters rise, so does the number of dead. In this village, the wind and the rain have caused devastation. There's no power and a short supply of clean water. This 14-year-old girl described how she was sleeping and woke up because she felt like she was floating, but realized she was actually in water. Her and her mother managed to save some food, but she lost all her school books. For emergency teams, the sheer scale of the damage means it's hard to administer aid. With trees down and debris across roads, reaching communities is a constant challenge.
Rescue efforts are number one at the moment. Secondary is making sure those people have survived, have access to food, water and shelter. Also, access to healthcare is another key thing because people will have been injured in the floods. Also, like the risk of disease outbreaks is so high in these sorts of conditions.
But in neighbouring Zimbabwe, help is starting to get through. Soldiers handing out food to cut off communities. This man walking miles to reach safety.
I have walked about 28 kilometres from Chiman, from Ngangu location, up to the skyline. There is no bridge. All bridges were swept away.
As parts of Mozambique are submerged underwater, emergency workers say this is the worst flooding in 20 years. There are fears up to 1,000 people could die, with many more missing. The human cost of this natural disaster. Catherine Nash, 5 News.